Hello everybody, this is Angie, and what I have for you today is another dollar idea. I do have a series of dollar idea videos, and what I did on every video that I call dollar idea, I set two challenges for myself. First of all, with any article that I work on can only cost a dollar, a little less, but not more. The other thing is I must only use what I have in my craft room. And what I have for you today are personalized flower pots. Very, very nicely personalized with a pretty label and a nice little saucer. And you can get these flower pots for a dollar, the flower pot and the saucer, for a dollar or less in most of the hobby stores, in Walmart, and most of the garden centers also. So I will go ahead and I will get started on telling you how I did this. Be right back. Okay, for your project, you will need a 4 1/4 inch terracotta flower pot and a little saucer if you'd like. Don't need it, but I think it looks so much more finished and pretty. Won't cost you more than a dollar. I use Mod Podge, but any liquid glue will do. And I use 3 different paints for my craft room. Let's see, white, a light gray, and a pink. And I swirl those around to give it depth and different color looks to make it look a little bit more vintage and used and things. And, of course, you're going to need your graphics. And for that, I go to my favorite site of all times. It's called The Graphics Fairy. I love her site. She has beautiful vintage images. They're all free. And she's got a lot of blank labels that you can use, or any image that you want to use. And let's see. Oh, yeah. And I will put her website up here. But I just love her her free images. They're all vintage. They're all lovely. And she's got a lot of blank labels. And if I repeat myself, please forgive me because I'm a little tired right now doing this video. But anyway, after you have that, you go ahead and paint it any color you want. I mean, if it's for a child, you get your favorite colors for a child. Now, this is terracotta. It's extremely porous. So be prepared to work quickly. Because I noticed as soon as I started painting, that paint just got sucked up into the terracotta. And I had to work very kind of quickly, you know, with my brushes and all, and swirl it around and everything. With your acrylic paints, you can kind of sponge it around and everything, but just be prepared that it's very porous. Okay, after you get it painted, let it sit and dry for a little while, and you get your graphic. And what I did was I went to the Graphics Fairy website, and she had this blank label, and it's so ornate, so pretty. And I wanted to do something for my sis because her birthday's next month. And what I did was I went to, I think I went into paint shop, and I wrote her name, Maureen. One of my favorite scripts is the real ornate one. And I wrote her name, Maureen. And I wanted to put something else here, so I thought, her birthday. So I put EST for established in 1946, because that's when she was born. And then I darkened the label a couple of times, and of course you have to resize it. So it'll fit on your flower pot. And then, let's see, I think then you just go on and you get your Mod Podge. Again, be prepared to work quickly. I fussy cutted as best as I can, fussy cut, the label, because of course when it prints out, it's on your printing paper. And I went in and out and did a little bit of intricate fussy cutting. And then I had my label ready. And again, when you put that Mod Podge layer on, excuse me, allergies, put a little bit of Mod Podge on your flower pot to begin with. Be prepared. I hate to repeat, you know, over this, but it's very important. Be prepared to work quickly. Put a little layer of Mod Podge over the area, and then take your label and put a thin layer of Mod Podge on the back of your label. Put it where you want it, working very quickly, and move it out. And if you have any glue, don't put too much, please, because your label will start to buckle. Smooth out your label. Smooth it out real well. And if any of the glue kind of squishes out, go ahead and just wipe that up. But it dries so quickly, and I can't stress that enough, because I actually did one, and I didn't have it straight, so I had to wash it off. And you could do that, you know, because it's paper. I had to wash it off, and then I had to repaint it a little bit and touch it up. But it's so quick. It's so much fun. And you could, of course, even put a photo or anything. If you can print it on paper, you can put it on this flower pot. But I just love the idea of personalizing it and putting a name on here and making it very personal to my sister, because, of course, I love her to death. Not to death. I love her, love her, love her. But I'm getting goofy. I'm getting punchy. But anyway, you go ahead and put some paint on your little saucer, too. And you have a lovely way to give a gift. Now, one of the things I will remind you of is at this point in time, if you do want to give someone a plant, this is not watertight. You know, so you have to get some type of sealant. I think they sell the sealant sprays and all in the stores. So you are going to have to seal this if you want to put a plant in it. But what I did was I took, and just for the demo, took a little bag of candy. Oh, yeah, the other caveat also is when I don't know if it's lead-free, I don't put food directly into anything. But I wrapped up some M&Ms that I had left over from, what was that, the last holiday. Anyway, and put them in one of these Dollar Tree bags and sealed it up with some ribbon and plopped it right in there. But now you could put any gift in here, a little gift of jewelry or whatever, and it's ready to go. If you want to bake cookies, you could do that. Anything you want to put in here that'll fit, of course. It's just ready to go. And you have a very inexpensive gifty that you could give, and they have their name on it. And I just think it looks so pretty. And I'm just saying that because, of course, I didn't draw this, but it does make a very nice and thoughtful gift. Now, one other thing is, I think I've said everything. If not, I'll just type some more instructions up here, because I did mention most of the important things. But I originally got this idea off of a blog where a lady talked about, and she did a beautiful job, about how to transfer a label onto a flower pot, the image, by reversing the print and actually pasting that that label, reversing it onto the flower pot, and later on, after you wait like 24 hours, you take the label off and it's there. It's not a label anymore. It's actually transferred onto the flower pot. And it took me 2.5 days to do this one. So I think it comes out pretty looking like an antique, but it was so tedious. It was so much work for me to learn processes and everything that I didn't want to give this as my dollar idea. But if you think of doing it that way, I will put the blog address up here, and you can look that up if you want to try it out, try your hand. But that's another option. But this was so quick. This was so quick. And if you're looking for a really quick gift idea, a quick party idea, this will be for you. And don't forget, you know, if you want to put a plant in there, to use a sealant. Okay, so that does it for my dollar idea of personalizing the flower pot. And again, if you have any questions, please feel free to jot them down there. I thank you so much for all your wonderful comments. It encourages me so much and it makes my day. So thank you so much for that. And let's see what else. Oh yes, I am wishing you a wonderful creative day. Bye now.